Mining cryptocurrency on a Raspberry Pi has never been possible. But that is all changing right now thanks to a cryptocurrency called Chia.
The internet is abuzz, Jeff, and we've been fielding questions through Linux Tech Show on YouTube. And Jeff has curated the top 10.
I'm gonna start right at the top. How big does my hard drive have to be to mine Chia?
All right, well, I guess technically, I mean, if you had a 500 gig hard drive, you'd have enough space for four plots, so you could farm Chia on a 500 gig hard drive, but that's, I mean, that's gonna take years before you see any revenue. So if the idea is to try to bring in revenue, which, you know, why do we farm or mine or whatever you want to call it, the best thing for you to do is to put as much storage into that as you possibly can. I would say the starting point would be about 4 terabytes. Anything under that is just going to take way too long for you to monetize it. So look at like the proof of work way of mining cryptocurrency. So this is Bitcoin, Ethereum, those kinds of things. You're basically throwing a lot of hardware at things like the GPU or possibly an ASIC. It's all going to be like the more powerful of a GPU you can put into that, the more you're going to be able to mine and the faster you're going to be able to mine it. Now, with Chia, it's exactly the opposite of that. It has nothing to do with GPU or CPU or anything like that. It's all to do with storage. So the more space you can give it, and space is pretty cheap, the more space you can give it, the more plots you can place into that storage, which is your farm. And the more plots you have, the faster you're going to see Chia and the more Chia you're going to see. So you're going to be able to monetize that much, much quicker and probably get a lot more. So I'd say about 4 terabytes is where I would start and up from there. I mean, if you have a 10 terabyte hard drive kicking around, fantastic. That'll do just great. But a 4 terabyte would be a good starting point. Then there's the NVMe side of things. So a plotter is not a farm. So you may have been kind of chewing on this, what is a plotter versus a farm, because you're looking at Chia Coin and wondering how that all plays in. So yes, the farm can be like a Raspberry Pi microcomputer with an external 10 terabyte USB hard drive. Perfect. That's your farm. That's what's going to be running 24/7, earning you Chia Coin. But the initial step is you have to prepare that hard drive for the farm by adding plots. And that is a proof of work style process. So that means you're going to need a pretty powerful system, such as your gaming PC. You probably have a better computer, like a good powerful computer at home, or something that you can stick an NVMe in, perhaps with a PCI Express riser, an NVMe chip of at least 480 gigabytes, because that will do one plot at a time, and it will then move it to your farm and move it and move it and do one at a time. But considering it might take 8 or 15 hours for you to create one plot, you probably want to get a larger NVMe drive for the plotter. So if you have a 2 terabyte NVMe drive, you might be able to pull as much as about 7 plots at a time. And then when it creates those plots, it will move those, and it will keep, so you're basically expediting the plots on your farm, which means your farm hard drive storage is going to fill up quicker. And once you have all your plots on that hard drive, you're farming them, and you have a higher chance with the more plots that you have. So
makes sense.
I know it's hard to get our heads around, but essentially look at it this way, just to kind of wrap up, because I think I've answered the question, but it's a little bit technical. Your farm should have the biggest amount of storage you can put in it. And it doesn't have to be anything fancy. They can be 5,400 RPM USB drives, like spinning drives. You don't want to use flash drives for this, but something that you can plug into a Raspberry Pi over USB 3 would be great. That's for your farm. But for your plotter, it has to be fast NVMe. You can do it on other hardware, but it's just going to burn it out, and you are going to burn through NVMe drives. So factor that into your cost to start up. Like, use an NVMe drive knowing that you're going to burn it out. And please, for goodness sake, do not, just out of courtesy, because, you know, we want to build a community around Chia that is considerate, and part of that is you are not going to go and buy an NVMe drive, burn it out doing plots, and then return it under warranty and get another one. Please don't do that.
No.
This is a consumable. You know that you're going to be burning through your NVMe drive, but know that going into this. If you've got an NVMe in your computer, don't use that. You need to buy one specifically that is a consumable in order to plot to that farm. And the bigger your NVMe drive is, the more plots you can create simultaneously. The bigger your farm storage is, that's the spinning drive, the more plots you can store and farm, and the greater chance you have of getting Chia faster.
Okay, that makes sense.
I hope that answers the question. I mean, it's a long-winded answer, but...
No, but it totally makes sense. And knowing that that's how it works, mm-hmm. you need to factor in both those aspects from the storage standpoint.
Yep.
Now, what happens if you don't have an NVMe? Can you just use your computer's hard drive?
Well, you can't use your computer's hard drive because, as I say, you're going to burn it out. So you don't want to burn out your computer's hard drive, right? Because then you're not going to be able to boot your computer. Don't do that. Absolutely don't do that. There's a small investment there. Get a PCIe riser and make sure you've got a PCI Express port in your computer that you can plug it into, and an NVMe. Probably active cooling if you can, would probably help keep it cooler, which will extend the life of it so you can get more plots. And you have to do it that way. I mean, yes, you could use an SSD, but you're gonna burn through consumer SSDs, and it's gonna be extremely slow. This graphic shows that an SATA SSD is gonna be about 550 megabytes per second sustained throughput. An NVMe SSD is gonna be 3,000. That's approximate, but just gives you a really good understanding of the fact that you don't want to do this on traditional consumer gear. You need to have an NVMe in order to do your plotting.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Now, because this is all done through hard drives and it's not a GPU or CPU based mining, mm-hmm. what happens if the hard drive failed? Do you lose your Chia?
Well, that's a great question. So you've created your plots and then you've been farming it for a while, and then your hard drive that is holding those plots crashes. What happens to the Chia that you've farmed? The plots that you've created will be lost in that case. The plots, okay? So you will have to put in a new hard drive and create new plots, unless for some reason you've created a backup, but realistically you'd probably just create new plots. The cryptocurrency that you have farmed already will be associated with your Chia wallet. So the Chia coin itself, because it's a decentralized cryptocurrency, is not on your hard drive. Okay, understand that. As long as you've backed up your mnemonic keys, which is something that you probably understand already, that's something that's your first step when you first install the Chia blockchain, is you're going to create your keys, back up that key, which is a long string of a bunch of words, and then you're going to be able to just, it's completely portable. So you would lose your plots, Jeff, but you would not lose your cryptocurrency. You'd probably lose a bunch of time because you'd have to create more plots on a new hard drive. But so it goes. Some people will use a RAID in that, to protect against that kind of thing, so that they can just rebuild the drive without having to replot. It is what it is. But you're not going to lose your cryptocurrency. And that said, the plots, you're going to continually use the same plots over and over again. So,
yeah.
You don't have to recreate the plots at any time.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
So when it comes, one of the other questions we have. When it comes to setting up the plots,
yeah.
one of the options is to delay the plots.
Oh.
And so the question, the comment that came in with the question is, I can't really find any information about that. And people I have seen say to just put in a random number. What is this?
Come on.
That never sounds like a good idea.
No.
But what is this feature, and do I really need to put in a delay?
You don't need to put in a delay. I would suggest that as you're just learning how to Chia farm, and when you're just learning to plot, I should say, just leave that at zero, because you're going to create your queue, and then you're going to allow it to run and create the plots and move them, and then you're going to create another one. There's a bit of a manual process there and a little bit of supervision. Once a day, you're going to go on and create more plots. Now, that said, as you get better at it and as you learn how it works, you can use the delay feature in order to automate that process. Here's essentially how that works. So the first couple of times that you run through the plotting process, you're going to want to then, at the end of it, look at your logs and see how long it takes for each stage of the plotting process. Now, after the first stage of the plotting process, you can start another plotting process because, for example, if it's working away on the NVMe and then it finishes that process, and then it moves over to working away on the RAM, and then it finishes that process and moves away to working on the CPU, because it's a multi-staged plotting process. Well, because the NVMe end of things is done, you can start another process and let it start working on the NVMe, as long as you've got the storage for it. Right. So I would say leave the delay off for now, as you're just learning, and then as you grow and as you want to try to experiment, because this is all you're going to be trying to find settings that work well for you, you can actually delay it. So you look at that time, and to keep it simple, say you find that the plot process, it's about 30 to 40% into the process where it finishes working on the NVMe and then starts moving on to the other factors of the plot. Okay. So at that point, so if you determine that takes 4 hours, you can set your delay to 4 hours and then create another process to start plotting more. And it will then, while it's still plotting the first process, but it's doing it in RAM or in the CPU, it will begin plotting on the NVMe for the next process. So now all of a sudden, you're plotting 8 or 10 or 14 plots at the same time, because they're each working on a different section of the plot. But we're getting very sophisticated there. We're not ready for that yet. Just start with a zero delay, and that's going to allow you to just kind of learn your way, and it's a safer way to go, because you might, you know, if you max out your NVMe during a plotting process, it will just, you'll lose all your plots and all the work that it's yeah. done.
Don't yeah. want to do that.
And you're burning that, and remember, there's a finite life to that NVMe, so the more you write to it, the sooner it's going to die.
Now, Robbie, I know we said we had top 10 questions about Chia, but we've run out of time.
Oh!
So
oh.
we're going to have to cut it short.
I talk too much. That's what YouTube tells me. But hey, make sure you subscribe to our channel, because we are actually going to break this into two parts. We're going to post the second part, the next bunch of questions from you, our viewers at Linux Tech Show, on YouTube in a couple of days. So make sure you're subscribed and get the notification by clicking the bell. You know how that works. And we will be back with more of your Chia questions. See ya.
Bye.